Hello everyone, welcome back to computer class. Today I am going to continue internet online surfing chapter. First is about content. First one, meaningful terms related to email. Second, about a Google Drive. Third, downloading Google Drive to your system. First is about some of the meaningful terms related to email. Before going to use the email, you need to know some of the meaningful terms. Okay. First one is about inbox. Do you know what is the meaning of inbox? Inbox is like a letter box. Okay. It will store whatever message you will get for your mail, whatever message is coming or whatever message is already came, whatever. Okay. It will store all the messages of your mail. Okay, that is about inbox. Whatever the message is received from other person, that is stored in a inbox. You can click on the inbox directly, you can read the message one more time, you can access the message, you can delete the message, whatever. That is about the inbox. Second one, outbox. One more name of outbox is sent mail. Okay, whatever message you have sent to other person, every messages will be stored in a outbox. Sometime because of a technical issue, because of internet connection, some messages won't send. Okay, those kind of message you can send one more time. Again, you can send by using a send option. No need to type one more time, no need to select the option, everything. Directly you can open the send mail. Whatever message is not sent, everything will be there only. Click on that message and resend the message one more time. Okay, that is about outbox or send mail. Third one is about spam. Spam means what? You may get unwanted messages or the messages containing a virus. Those kind of messages will be stored in a spam folder. Okay. Unwanted messages means mainly it will be about the advertisement of a product or some unknown person may send a virus through a email. Okay. Those kind of junk mail. Okay. Junk mail received from unknown sources will be stored in a spam folder. Those kind of messages is called as a spam messages. Okay. Those kind of messages will harm your system. Okay. Unwanted website link may appear, or the messages from an unknown person about the lot of advertisement about the company or the offers of a company, whatever. That is about spam. Next is about trash. Okay, trash is a one folder in an email. Okay, if you don't want the messages, means you will delete those messages, right? Those deleted messages will be stored in a trash, like a recycle bin. Okay, whatever the message you will delete, the deleted messages, every deleted messages will be stored in a trash folder. Okay, and for this also, some limited time will be there. Means the deleted messages will appear in a trash folder only up to 30 days. After 30 days, whatever the messages will be there in a trash, every messages after 30 days, it will be deleted. Okay. The time period will be there. For each messages, 30 day time period will be there. 30 day over means the messages will be deleted automatically from a trash folder. Within a 30 days, if you fail to open that message or if you want to access that message one more time, is you can go to trash folder and you can open one more time and you can take it one more time. That is about trash folder. Next is about CC. The meaning of CC is carbon copy. Okay. Here, if you are going to send the messages, before that, under a CC option, you have entered other person mail ID. Okay. You are going to send the messages to school or other person. In a under a CC, I have entered my friend mail ID. Okay. Whatever message I'll send to other person or to the school or wherever, same as it is, copy of a messages will get by a my friend. Okay. You are getting right. CC means carbon copy. Under a CC, we need to if you entered any mail ID, okay, that person will get whatever message you are sending to other person or to the school or to other person or to the company, whatever. Every messages, one more copy of the messages will get by that person. Okay, that is about the carbon copy. Second one is about blind carbon copy. BCC means blind carbon copy. If you use the CC, means the messages will get by my friend and also by other company and all, right? They will get to know this message will send to other person also. Okay, my school will get to know to whom, who is the carbon copy of this message. Everything will get to know by the school or to the company or whoever. But in a BCC, it is a blind carbon copy. The receiver won't get to know who is sending the messages or who is getting this same message as a copy. This is about a blind carbon copy. Okay. Next is about logging in. Logging in is nothing but signing in. I have said, you have already got about this, right? Logging in about the means signing in. This is the first step. You need to log into your email ID to access or to receive the messages from the other person or to send the messages to the other person. This is the first step we need to follow while opening a mail ID. Next is about logout. Okay, logout is nothing but logging out or a signing out. This is the last step we need to follow. Okay, we need to log off our mail ID after our work, or else somebody may hack your email ID. Okay, so you need to log out your mail ID by using the mail ID and the email. Directly you can click on the right side option will be there, right? Directly you can click and you can log off your mail ID easily. Next topic is about Google Drive. Okay, Google Drive is a storage space provided by a Google. Okay, extra 15 GB storage space you will get to your system or to your mobile also you will get. Okay, it is provided by a Google. Okay, if you don't have a lot of memory in your mobile, or else if your storage in internal storage or the external storage is less, means you can use this Google Drive option also. This is very secured also. Okay, it is provided by a Google Drive, like the hard disk of your computer. How your computer will be having the hard disk, defaultly some storage space will be there, right? Same as it is, it will act as a hard disk also. One more name of a Google Drive is cloud storage. For this Google Drive, one more name is cloud storage. Okay, if in your mobile you have stored in a Google Drive lot of pictures or videos, okay, Google Drive will take your mail ID and password also while opening and while saving or everything. Okay, same document you want to open but you don't have mobile with you. Okay, in your mobile you have downloaded the Google Drive and you have saved some pictures and some videos, whatever, but now you are going to open that mail or Google Drive and you want one picture but you don't have a mobile, means whatever, wherever you will get the system, connect to the Google Drive, open the Google Drive and type the mail ID and password, same Google Drive, same your mobile Google Drive will appear there. Okay, Google Drive is like a cloud storage. Okay, it won't store in a one system, it will be stored in a cloud, like a cloud. Okay, don't think it will store in a cloud. Okay, it will store like a cloud storage. We will call it as a cloud storage for this. Okay, whenever you want, wherever you want, you can access easily. This is about Google Drive. Next is about downloading Google Drive. Defaultly for the system, Google Drive will be there. If you want to download the Google Drive to your desktop or whatever, means we will follow some steps. Click the internet browser, means any browser you can open, Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox, any browser you can open, and enter the web link as, and like type this link in the search box. Okay, www.google.com/drive/download. Okay, type this link in the search option, then you will get the Google Drive page will appear like this. You can see this image, right? Like this, so many links will appear. First you click on that first one option, or else if you click here, we are using the link, right? If you are using the link, means it will open one default page, directly one page will appear. Okay, instead of this link you can type download Google Drive, like that also you can type, or else if you type this link, means directly it will show, it will appear one screen, Google Drive screen only it will appear. Next, click the download option. In that option, downside green color download option will be there. You can click the download option. Then after download, it will ask you to accept and install. Okay, click on the accept and install option. Then download, install, everything is over. Welcome window will appear. Okay, Google Drive first window will appear. Then click on the get started option. Then finally click on the done. Now downloaded, everything is over. How you will download the app, right? How you will download other apps to your system? Same as it is this also. Open any browser, then click on type this link on the search box. Okay, afterwards Google Drive page will appear. In that click on the download option. Next, after download it will ask you to click on the accept and install. Click on that and click on the get started, and finally done. This is about downloading a Google Drive to your system. Thank you everyone. Have a nice day.